Learn about scaling Azure Functions on Kubernetes with KEDA in this first of two episodes of Azure Tips and Tricks. In this first video, we are going to create a containerized Azure function that is triggered by an Azure Storage queue. In the next video, we'll deploy the function to Azure Kubernetes service and scale it with KEDA. To follow along, you should have the following installed on your local machine: Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code with the Azure Workload or Functions extensions. You need Docker on your machine and the Azure CLI, and also node.js. You can find links to these prerequisites in the description of this video. All right, let's start by creating an Azure storage queue in the Azure portal. Here in the portal, I search for queue. This brings up Azure storage. And create it. Okay. So first, I'll pick a resource group. And now, I'll give the storage account a name, like this. All right. I'll leave the rest and click Review and Create. And I'll create it after this, which can take a while, so I'll skip ahead. And there is the storage account. Now let's create a new queue in it. Here we go. So let's click Add Queue here. That's it. And give the queue a name. And OK, create a queue. That was simple. Here it is. And as you can see, there are no messages in the queue. Good. We need the name of the queue for later. And we also need the access key to connect to Azure Storage, which you can find here. All right, let's switch to the Azure CLI. In here, we'll start by installing the Azure Functions core tools with this command. We need this to create function apps on our local machine. And that's it. Okay, let's clear it. And now I'll create a new directory that we'll use to create the function in. That's it. And we are in the directory. Okay, we create the function app with func init docker. And here I pick .NET, as I want a .NET-based function app. There we go. This has created a function app in my directory, complete with Docker file to run it in a container. Okay, let's clear it again. Next, I'll create a function in the function app. And I'll choose the queue trigger to start it. Okay. Now give it a name, like this. And that's it. We now have a containerized function. Let's switch to Visual Studio. In here, I've opened the function app project file. Here is the function app with the Docker file. The Docker file states that it will simply publish everything from the function app into a container and run the function there using the Azure Functions runtime. All right, let's go to the settings. Because in here, we need to add a new setting, this one. This is the access key to Azure Storage. And now, in queuefunction.cs, I need to change this. I need to point this to my queue name and to the access key in local.settings.json. That's it. Let's switch back to the Azure CLI. Before we move on to the next video, I want to test if the container compiles with this command. Before you run this, you need to make sure that you are logged into your local Docker by running docker login. And that's it. The function compiles and I now have a local container with the function in it. Cool! In the next video, we'll deploy this container to Azure Kubernetes service and make it scale with KEDA.